start the second half. And Michigan, of course, will receive. They kicked off to start the game and will defend the goal to our left. Although the breeze, a slight breeze from right to left start of the game, the flags are hanging limp at the moment. The official statistics of the first half, Erland Olsen, indicate Washington outgained the Wolverines 2-1.
Actually had 14 first downs to just 7 from Michigan. And interesting how they gained those. 11 by pass, 3 by run. Michigan had 5 by run and 2 by pass. Time of possession not quite as unbalanced as you would expect with that imbalance in first downs. Total yardage very heavily on the part of very heavily in favor of Washington. But as we said, the most important stat, the score on the board. And in that statistic, Washington is 1 point behind the Wolverines of Michigan.
Leading individual players, Merlin, Butch Wolfolk, the leading rusher, 97 yards for Michigan. Kyle Stevens, 51 for Washington. Passing, Wangler was only 2 of 6 for 26 yards. Flick for Don James Huskies. There he is, 15 for 23, 189 yards, had 1 intercepted.
One of the things you really have to be concerned about is not losing your emotional edge. And it's been a very emotional first half, especially for these Washington Huskies. They'll be kicking the ball off from the hash mark. Important that they get things started right in this second half.
Washington's defense successfully kept the ball away from Anthony Carter. He ran the ball once for just a couple of yards. He, in the first half, did not catch a pass. And now he lines up in that stack with Stan Edwards. They try to disguise where Carter will be, hoping he will move to the side that the ball is being kicked. But Nelson's kicks were so long, it didn't matter much anyway in the first half. Carter at the one. Anthony Carter in the open field. Oh, as he hit at the 16-yard line. And bounces to his feet, as he almost always does. He's amazing, 155 pounds. Led the nation in kickoff returns with that 29.4 average.
Carter drives himself right into the corner of the end zone. That's a superb kick by Nelson. Watch Newsom, number 23. He hits him right in the air, puts that headgear on the football. That's one of the toughest 155 pounders you'll find anywhere.
Number 30, Chris O'Connor, finished the tackle. First play, it's Stan Edwards. No gain. The fullback for the Wolverines ran right into Mark Giroux, number 67, the nose guard for the Huskies.
Dick, I think the biggest surprise to me in this game was the way the Washington defense has played. And they have started the second half the way they played the first half.
Check that offense. Reset it for you for Michigan. John Wangler is the quarterback. He has Butch Wolfolk and Stan Edwards behind him. Alan Mitchell and the All-American Anthony Carter, number one of the wide receivers. Tight end is Norm Betts. The line of Lilja, Powers and Becker at guard, Paris and Moransky at tackle, all Big Ten performers. Flags are down. Carter with the ball. And Bill Stapleton wraps him up at the 19-yard line. Stapleton, hiding behind all of those white jersey blockers, just kind of slipped through and made the tackle after a short gain. That was Carter's first reception, and a flag is down. Offside, Michigan.
I don't think they'll take it. I think they'll take the down away from him. Not much made in the way of yardage.
Offside, offense.
By the way, Bill Love's microphone is a first in Rose Bowl history, as so many firsts have been established between the Rose Bowl and NBC. First time that an official has used a microphone during the course of play. Defensively for the Washington Huskies, Jenkins, Giroux, and Olsen up front. The linebackers, Gagliardi, Driscoll, McLean, and Stewart, with Horton and Stapleton at the corners, Gardner and Harvey at safety. Third down, 7, Wangler dumps it out to Wolfolk, and he has a first down at the Michigan 30. Driscoll and Harvey made the tackle. First down, Mason Blue.
You have to set your priorities defensively, and they've obviously, on the Washington side of the line of scrimmage, decided to stop Carter. They were covering him very carefully, and they made room for Wolfolk. He took advantage of that, has the first down on the 30.
And good blocking for Wangler. He had plenty of time to find Wolfolk. A toss to Wolfolk. And a vicious tackle at the 32-yard line. And Giroux with another crisp hit for Washington.
Kurt Becker had Kenny Driscoll about 10 yards down the field, still blocking him as the whistle was blown, and Driscoll turned around and popped him one. The official said, hey, none of that.
Butch Wolfolk now with 100 yards for the Wolverines. Second down, 8. And Wolfolk has a first down at the 41-yard line before Ken Gardner, number 29, can make the tackle.
Excellent faking on that play by Wangler. In fact, he had the secondary still convinced it was a pass, even though the play was well underway. Watch him as he hands the ball off and then goes back to fake the pass. Wolfolk just exploding through the line of scrimmage. We talked about the size advantage that Michigan has offensively. They may begin to capitalize on it more and more in the second half.
This is Stan Edwards. He bowls his way to the 44, second and 7. Butch Wolfolk from Westfield, New Jersey. Want to go back to him. He's just a junior. He'll be back at 207 pounds. He qualified for the Olympic trials in the 100 meters. He has run a 10-1 wind-aided 100 meters. That's world class. And he carries 207 pounds, which we told you is the leading rusher as a sophomore and again the leading rusher this year. And Don James trying to figure out a way to stop him. Carter is not in the game. They're using two tight ends, Christian and Betts. Jenkins did not get back onside. That's Wolfolk. And he's all the way to the Washington 42 before Driscoll can trip him up. It's a Michigan first down.
A good lesson in that play, Dick. I think the whole defensive team saw the flags in the air. They kind of stopped. But the penalty will go against the defense. And obviously, Michigan will refuse it and take the big gain. You can't stop. You've got to play it out defensively.
Bo Schembechler.
The move right there by number 65. Fletcher did not get back in time. He'll be ticketed. Now watch, a lot of the defensive players just kind of stopping here. Not Butch Wolfolk. He's going full speed. Kenny Driscoll finally over there, number 40, to stop him. But it's a big gainer.
He was the Big 10 outdoor 200-meter champion and second in the 100 meters. Michigan on the march, leading 7-6 early in the third quarter. Don't forget the Orange Bowl to follow. Florida State and Oklahoma. Wangler almost intercepted as Ken Driscoll, number 40, shot in front of the intended receiver, Stan Edwards. And good pressure from Rusty Olsen from that defensive right side.
I think that Wangler felt the pressure, had to get rid of that ball a little sooner than he wanted to. Both quarterbacks have had relatively good, in fact, excellent protection on this day. But I think Flick has certainly been the more capable passer, although Michigan, by nature and by offensive choice, has gone to the running game much more often than they have to the pass.
Anthony Carter, number 1, is flanked right. And Alan Mitchell back into the game is split left.
Watch it draw!
Wangler to throw. Complete to Betts at the 37. That won't be good enough for a first down. Ken Gardner, the weak safety, with a quick reaction, made the tackle and will bring up third and about 5.
We talked about some of the differences between these teams offensively. One of the differences defensively is that Washington will jump its defensive linemen half a gap one way or the other to put them in a different position after the audible has been called. The other team, Michigan, will slant their linemen one way or the other. Just a difference in the way the game is being played on the line of scrimmage.
Complete to Carter. And he's to the 11-yard line. Anthony Carter.
There are a few players in every game that when they get the football, they make your stomach knot up. Anthony Carter is one of those, and he just about waltzed it into the end zone.
Look at the legs. His thighs are about the same size as his calves.
What a beautiful move he put on Horton. He put Horton on the ground, although Horton coming back in time to put a necktie on him.
Michigan leading 7-6, first down at the 11. Wolfolk. in trouble, and he can't get back to the line of scrimmage. Brett Gagliardi led the defensive charge for Washington at the 12. It'll be second and 11. And Wolfolk upset with himself for at least the development or the lack thereof of that last play. He's had a big day. Look at those numbers, 120 yards. His best day all season involved the game in Indiana when he ran 64 yards, the longest scrimmage play of the season. Look, he's got legs like Enberg. Only I can't move. 155 pounds, but how tough he is. This is the 12th play in this drive. Wangler to the 9, maybe the 8-yard line. Driscoll made the tackle of Wolfolk. And it's 3rd and 8.
Washington's defense doing a good job on that play, getting outside. They don't have quite the team speed defensively that a lot of teams have, but they have played highly emotional football here today. They'd like to keep Michigan out of the end zone, hold them to 3 points, or preferably take it away from them and give them nothing here.
Carter to the top of your screen, two tight ends. Wangler looking for Carter. Wide open. So close to a touchdown. Wangler dropping it into Dunaway, and he couldn't wrestle it away.
One of the Michigan coaches indicated that their tight ends are primarily blockers and not pass receivers, although we have seen Betts catch a couple of passes today. That's one that could have been caught. I'm sure Dunaway will dream about that for many weeks and months to come.
Haji Sheik, Ali Haji Sheik, from 25 yards away. It's good. And the sophomore, his father attended the University of Michigan and is now an instructor in mechanical engineering down at the University of Texas at Arlington. And I'm sure he's watching, cheering. His son was given Michigan a 4-point lead. 8:48 left in the third quarter. Michigan by 4.
The value of a backup quarterback, Rich Hewlett, here. Watch him take a bad snap and get it down in time. Kicker gets it up through. Good timing, good coordination. Boy, you don't want to blow one of those. And the pace of scoring picking up. The last 4 possessions all have resulted in scores, Dick.
And that, Merlin, was a long drive with the opening kickoff of this second half from the Michigan 15 all the way to the Washington 8 before the field goal. That's Allen at the 10. And into traffic, can't make it to the 20-yard line. He stopped at about the 18. Nice coverage for Michigan. 93, Mike Lemoran from Grafton, Wisconsin, down in a hurry to be a part of that tackle.
Love those linebackers on your kicking teams. They're ideally equipped for that kind of play.
10-6, Michigan leads it with 8:43 remaining in this third quarter. Tom Flick, the quarterback, to Sean Tyler, and Kyle Stevens behind him. Scancy to the left. Aaron Williams to the right. Flick complete to Tyler, and the big fullback has run out of bounds at the 27, close to a first down. Ryan Carpenter, the tackler.
Good, smart play calling on the part of the Washington Huskies. Bob Stoll, their offensive coordinator, they've repeatedly taken advantage of the outside areas of Michigan's defense. You see one of the Michigan coaches exhorting his troops. They want a few more points on that board. Certainly nothing safe in the way of a lead. One touchdown would put Washington back on top.
2nd and 1. And Flick to Stevens. And a good solid hit. Stevens was able to fall forward and close to a first down. They may require a measurement. But the defense of the Wolverines, helped by Tony Jackson, who came up from the secondary.
I'm a little surprised by that call. An ideal opportunity, I would think, maybe to go for a bomb or a big play with 2nd and very short yardage. Washington, uncharacteristically, being conservative.
Leroy Lutu, number 81, has come in for Washington, a second tight end, as you see the measurement. Just enough.
We actually had three tight ends in there, Dick. Ron Wheeler, number 85. I guess they were going to go with all three of them if it were not, in fact, the first down.
So they leave the game, and the three outside men come in, Scancy and Williams, along with Kyle Stevens. Back into the backfield. Don James looking through the setting sun for another victory in the Rose Bowl. And Bo Schembechler, that's incredible. The great coach of the Wolverines has never finished a year at Michigan with a victory. A tie with Ohio State, the best ending for him. Stevens acrobatically to the 31, a gain of three. Good year, Blimp. What a picture that is. It was so delightful to watch it during the halftime show of the marching bands to see those formations at the controls of that 192-foot blimp. Joel Chamberlain, veteran Goodyear pilot from Norwood, Massachusetts. Happy New Year, Joel. NBC's own George Simpson is on camera. Bill Betzner, video controls. Great job. What a picture. On second and seven, it's Flick over the middle, complete to Scancy. First down at the 50-yard line, 19 yards to Scancy.
Scancy starting in motion and then darting quickly into the secondary, getting a running start on the defender that was trying to come with him. And Flick, as he has been all day, right on target.
And his back's really picking up the Michigan blitzes, aren't they? They're consistently picking off the linebackers. Scancy was the most valuable player in the Sun Bowl last year when Washington beat Texas. Down the middle to Williams. Williams should have caught the ball, and then it was almost deflected to Tony Jackson.
Williams had caught a couple of passes earlier in the game. As we said, he's the favorite deep receiver of Tom Flick. Flick flicked that one right into his fingers. The ball bounced loose. That's certainly one of the easier balls to catch that we have seen all day. I'm sure Williams will dream about that one.
Flick, there are his statistics today. He's had a good day, one interception. His team trails Michigan 10-6. Stevens, just no room to run, gets to the Michigan 49. Paul Gergash, along with number 53 Mel Owens on the tackle. It'll be third down and eight for the Huskies of Washington. Bo Schembechler. Boy, it's been rough for him in Pasadena. You recall his first trip here 11 years ago, the 1970 game. Suffered the heart attack 2 years ago. He lost a game on the phantom touchdown by Charles White of USC. He's come up empty, 0 for 5. Again, they picked up the blitz. Scancy, and it's broken up by Brian Carpenter. Number 9, Carpenter, denied.
Same action that Scancy had started before, started in toward the quarterback, cut into the secondary, but instead of continuing on across, you'll see him yourself. Now he darts into the secondary. Instead of coming to his left, cuts to his right. Good adjustment by Carpenter, who cuts him in half there, although the ball had already bounced clean.
Rich Camarillo will punt it for Washington. Evan Cooper and Anthony Carter deep for Michigan. Carter just outside the 10. High kick, fairly short, but good coverage, and Cooper on the fair catch at the 16-yard line. Now Michigan with the lead will begin deep in its own end after a 33-yard punt. 6 minutes, 23 seconds left in the third quarter. It's Michigan 10, Washington 6. From Pasadena, we pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC Television Network. Michigan operating in front of its own fans, and they've set up a roar to try to encourage the Wolverines from their 16. Wolfuck dives to the 22. Well, some 75 million around the nation watching this, and also around the world, some of the countries that are watching the live telecast of this 67th Rose Bowl game. South America, Japan, people in London, Saudi Arabia tuned in live today. Happy New Year to you all. Let's hope it's a happy, healthy, and a peaceful one for all of us. Edwards dumped at the 24. Mark Giroux and Kent Driscoll are the tacklers. It's third and two.
Nick, in keeping with that long list of countries who have joined us for this telecast, interesting, I think, to observe that this is more than a football game. This is really an event, a spectacle. It transcends the interest even of football with the beautiful parade this morning and all of the excitement, the color, the pageantry. A very special opportunity for all of us here to be a part of a great occasion.
Amen. Third and two. Play action. Wide open is Christian. And he has a first down. An uncharacteristic Michigan call.
Well, they're gambling, and the gamble pays off. Wagler is on the throw. Not beautiful, not artistic at either end, but certainly effective.
Chuck Christian was not listed on the season statistics of having caught a pass all year for the University of Michigan. First down at the 34. Edwards. Mark Giroux's play in the middle of that Washington defense has really been evident on anything involving Edwards up the middle. He's just been there to smother it.
Giroux, the leading tackler on that defense for Washington. Unusual for a nose man to have that distinction.
Michigan has beaten Washington five times to one loss, but that loss, of course, was 3 years ago here in the Rose Bowl. Wangler, good protection. Is it good? Alan Mitchell. Yes, at the Washington 46. 16 yards.
We have doffed our hats to Tom Flick early in this game. Let's do the same to John Wangler. He zips this ball right on target, a little bit low, but his receiver digs it out for the catch.
Like a right fielder diving, make that shoestring job. Alan Mitchell, first down. Wolfuck on the draw. And he's all the way to the 36-yard line. And another first down, and he may be hurt as Jerry McLean, the senior linebacker for Washington, with a solid hit. And Wolfuck looked as if he was grabbing at his leg.
Chance to see it for yourself here. Wolfuck doing a good job of popping it to the outside, reading the defense so well as a runner, and getting down. He may have a cramp. We'd certainly hope it's nothing serious.
Michigan has another outstanding running back, Larry Ricks, who could replace him. We'll be back. We'll check on the condition of Wolfuck. 3:40 remaining, third quarter. Michigan 10, Husky 6. 3:40 left in the third quarter. Let's check how Butch Wolfuck was injured on that last carry.
Watch his knee at the end of this run as he is bent over and tackled. Would appear that he is, in fact, injured, that it was not a cramp. Watch the knee bent right back just at the point of impact there. He's been helped off the field.
He's been replaced by number 46, Larry Ricks, and Ricks gets the call immediately, and he is drawn a crowd of purple. Rusty Olsen and Fletcher Jenkins made the tackle. Larry Ricks is from Barberton, Ohio. That's the same hometown as his coach, Bo Schembechler, and the same high school that produced the All-American Billy Taylor from Michigan. He played in the 70 and 72 Rose Bowls. Ricks has had an outstanding year, 829 yards rushing, a 5.1 yard average, 5'10", 200 pounds. So not much difference statistically between Wolfuck and Ricks. To Carter. First down at the 24. Steve Polk, number 49, and Anthony Carter exchanging pleasantries after the play.
Beautiful slant pass, good route, and a little zip on that ball. I didn't know that Wangler had that kind of rifle in his arm.
14 yards to Carter, who has three catches all in this second half. Well, he's fearless. He runs that pattern inside right into the teeth of those defensive backs and linebackers. Ball at the 23. Carter acting like he wants to throw the ball. Out of bounds at the 14. Close to another first down.
When you come around the outside, there's no substitute for speed. This man has it. Watch him dipping back, taking the little toss. They get an extra blocker on the play that way. Number 46, Ricks out in front, but most of it is just made on the pure speed of number one, Anthony Carter.
Butch Wolfolk, as they work on that right knee. This
40 yards.
The mascot of the University of Washington, and he's hoping in that spirit that he can get those defensive players to stop Michigan. It's 10-6 Wolverines, and they're on the march again. Wangler wants to throw, going to run. Out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Mark Giroux, Ken Gardner, Jerry McLean all in on the tackle.
We've talked about a knee operation that took some of the speed from this fine young quarterback, but you didn't remove any of the heart. Watch him go for the extra yardage here. He'll pay a price for it, but he'll pay it gladly.
Second team academic All-American Wangler worked out 4 to 5 hours every day after the surgery last year. The doctor said, frankly, son, you won't play football again. He would not believe him. He got himself ready, and here he is, the quarterback in the Rose Bowl. Ricks feeling his way to the 7-yard line, where it'll be second and goal. Gagliardi with a tackle for Washington.
Physical superiority, the size and strength of that Michigan offensive line beginning to assert itself as we thought it might in the late going here.
Here comes Carter.
One of the things that happens, Dick, when you start to get tired, you lose some of that enthusiasm and some of that strength that keeps pumping from the adrenaline, and pure strength and size begin to take their toll.
This is the second long march by Michigan in the third quarter. The other to a field goal. This one, touchdown! In 2 years than anyone in Michigan history, Anthony Carter, and now the Wolverines have opened a 16-6 lead, and the try per point by Haji Sheik. It's good. Hail to the victors. John Philip Sousa called that fight song one of the three best marches ever written. 11 left, third quarter, Michigan 17, Washington 6. It's a distinct honor when a sophomore is voted the most valuable player by his teammates. Usually that goes to an offensive senior lineman, a co-captain, but the Michigan team acknowledged Carter, a quiet sophomore, off the field as their top performer this year. Now, Carter's touchdown from Wangler makes it 17-6. The kickoff by Haji Sheik, directed at Anthony Allen. And he runs rather gingerly out to the 22-yard line.
We talked about Schembechler and the plays being called. You see a huddle there between several of them. Schembechler finally said, hey, I'm going to call this play myself. Looked like he just made the call.
He said, throw the ball to number one.
Now watch. Let's watch the play. We talked about Carter as being the most exciting player on the field. That's the reason why. No move really here, just speed and driving to the open area, and a perfect toss by Wangler. Dick, the last three possessions by Michigan, drives of 80 yards for a touchdown, 83 for a field goal, and 83 for a touchdown.
Now he's trying to dominate the play. David Bale, the tight end, hit hard at the 26-yard line by Brian Carpenter, the junior from Flint, doing a solid job all day. They're a four-minute drive, and in this third quarter especially, Michigan, 10.5 minutes with the ball, Washington, 2.5 minutes. 25 plays to 7.
The big difference in this game, the second half, Michigan taking advantage of that domination. In the first half, when Washington was dominated, they weren't getting the points. Or when Washington was dominating, they were not getting the points on the board.
Kyle Stevens into a Michigan stone wall, and the biggest brick was Mike Turgovac, number 77. He was all Big Ten as a junior, and again all Big Ten this year. Bo Schembechler, what would it mean to win that last game? Merlin, can you help us to identify with his feelings?
Well, I know this, that when you lose that last game, especially a big game, a bowl game, one that you aimed at and pointed for, that stays in your throat, and everybody reminds you of that. Oh, what a catch.
And Marion Boddy, what a play, short of the first down. David Bale is stopped.
But as I was saying, Coach Schembechler will remember the game and the last series, the last plays of this game, I'm sure, will stick with him no matter what the outcome. He'd like it to be pleasant.
We're in the final minute of the third quarter. Michigan fans cheering their defense. Rich Camarillo, the punter for Washington. And back is Anthony Carter at the Michigan 30. With him is Evan Cooper. Good kick by Camarillo, but there's the man, Carter, at the 25. And he slips at the 30. Oh, he's a cat right back on his feet. A 49-yard kick by Camarillo. Clock stop. 5 seconds left in this, the third quarter. A quarter that has been all Michigan. They've outscored the Huskies 10-0. A hang glider who came flying right through the center of the stadium, fortunately a couple of hundred feet over the playing surface, and now out over the parking lot here in the Arroyo Seco.
Actually landing on the Brookside golf course here, Dick.
Final play of the third quarter. And Washington almost offside. Edwards. Sure-handed ball carrier to the 34. Mark Stewart with a tackle, and that's the end of the third quarter. The 67th Rose Bowl game has one quarter to go. The score, Michigan 17, Washington 6. We'll be right back after these messages from your local station.